Shalom, shalom. First and foremost, I want to give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rechak Wadash. I want to give double honors to my apostles and elders at Great Millstone who do rule and teach well. And I want to give a peace and salutations to all you Akim out there pushing this truth across the four winds so we can seal the elect and make it to the kingdom. All right, it's the brother Yerah, Lord willing, coming back to you through the spirit and power of Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, to feed the body and edify the sheep in all spirit, faith, truth, sincerity, and doctrine. All right, so as I got through watching this lesson right here from the brother Rapa, all right, and it was a beautiful lesson. You know, if bros haven't checked it out, you know, check it out. It's called Get Right or Good Night, Spiritual Preparations, all right? And right now, you know, bros have been doing a lot of, speaking with one another, you know, and, you know, admonishing one another, you know. It's been a lot of rebuke as well, you know. But it's all for the embetterment of our spirits, man, you know. Because the things are about to change, all right. You see, things are about to change and, you know, the spirit is about to turn up on the left-hand side with these devils. You know, we can easily see that this devil is about to, you know, start switching things up, shutting things down, cutting, you know, things off, you know, and making it real hard, you know, in the world, you know, and mainly, you know, coming against the men of the Lord, man, all right, and those that serve Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, all right? So, you know, we have to turn up on the right-hand side as well. You know, it's a balance with the Lord. You know, the Lord, you know, speaks about, you know, it speaks about in the scriptures how the Lord is a man of balance. Okay, the Lord is all about, you know, balance and not confusion. All right. So, you know, one of the things that, you know, sparked my spirit after watching this lesson was, you know, we have to, you know, check ourselves, man. You know, don't be afraid to check yourself. You know, in this truth, you know, one thing I've learned, you know, and I'm still learning, you know, by the way, you know, is to always check yourself, man. You know, the scriptures talk about, what does that scripture say? Examine thyself. All right. Examine thyself daily, you know? So, you know, one of the ways that, you know, you examine yourself daily, you know, like the brother had mentioned inside of this video here or this lesson, you know, it is, hey, if a day go by and he hasn't, you know, rebuked himself or rebuked, you know, certain thoughts that he might have, you know, he got to go back and, you know, examine his walk during that day, you know, because here, look, matter of fact, let's just get this scripture right here. The book of Sirach or Ecclesiasticus chapter 2 and verse 1, and it reads, "My son, if thou come to serve the Lord, prepare thy soul for temptation." All right. And your soul is your mind, man. OK, you have to prepare your mind for temptations. OK. All right. And and one thing I've learned and one thing I've been told, you know, coming into this truth, you know, being taught by great men, you know, is that, hey, your biggest enemy in this truth, you know, your biggest battle is going to be yourself, you know. And I can definitely contest that is true, you know, and I'm still learning that is true, you know, is that, you know, the hardest temptation that you're going to fight, you know, when coming to serve the Lord, all right, is going to be your flesh, man. You know, the doubts that come in your head, you know, I don't know enough, you know, or, you know, anything, man, you know. I'm pretty sure, you know, bros that have your hand to the plow, bros that are serving the Lord, you know, hey, you have your own personal testimonies and examples, man. All right. And don't think that, you know, it's something that you're going through personally, you know, that, you know, that you're the only one going through that, man. All right. You see, because that's not true, man. All right. I'm gonna grab that scripture too, you know, because all brethren are going through the same thing, man. All right. On different levels. But we're all being tried and tested, man. All right. You see? But it's only to make us better, you know. Continuing on, verse 2, it says, "Set thy heart aright." Okay, your heart meaning your mind, okay? The Hebrew word lab, which means your mind. All right, and constantly endure. See, so you got to constantly, you know, rebuke those weak thoughts, man, that come in your mind, man. All right, because Satan's gonna constantly put those weak thoughts in your mind. You know, you're gonna make mistakes. The scriptures talk about how a righteous man falleth, all right, seven times. All right, seven meaning a spiritual number, meaning completion. All right, you're gonna fall a complete amount of times. You might fall a lot of times, man. All right. Does that mean that, you know, you're not meant to be a man of the Lord or you're not meant to do this work? No, you know, but it's not about you falling. It's about you getting back up. OK, you learning from your mistakes. All right. You getting better. You know, it says and constantly endure. Constantly. That's the key word, man. Constantly endure. OK. And make not haste in time of trouble. Yeah. You know, when, you know, in your time of fall or, you know, you might make a mistake and, you know, get rebuked, right? Don't get offended, you know? You see, look, personal testimony, I battle that all the time, man, all right? You see, not getting offended, you know? You know, having to rebuke myself right in the moment, like, hey, man, shut the hell up, you know? And listen, you know? Because that's a big problem with these people in the world, man. Okay, they don't have a self-control, man. Okay, that's why these so-called men, they're not men, you know, because they can't control their own spirit, man. They don't have any self-control. They're all emotional, all over the place. See, we can't do that, you know. You see, we can't do that. You can't be a man of the Lord doing this work and you're just all emotional and just all over the place, man. You know, you're acting like a woman. You know, you can't do that. You know, we're leaders, man. You know, a leader can't be in doubt, you know, constantly in doubt and you know, emotional and all over the place, double minded and et cetera, man. You know, so we have to constantly endure, you know, rebuke those weak thoughts that Satan puts inside of our minds, man. All right. So like, let me continue. It says, cleave unto him and depart not. It says, depart not away, that thou mayest be increased at thy last end. Yeah, you know, because if you endure, all right, guess what? The Lord's going to give you spiritual gifts, man, okay? The Lord's going to increase you in certain areas, man. Increase your faith or, you know, increase your patience, you know. Increase your knowledge and wisdom, you know. You see? Increase your courage, you know. Certain areas that you might lack, you know. So just remember, every time you're going through something, it's because, you know, especially if you pray to the Lord and you ask the Lord, you know, to increase you in certain, you know, areas where you know you may lack, you know. And then all of a sudden, like a test comes about. Just know that test has something to do with whatever you asked, you know, you asked the Lord to increase you in, man. And you have to endure it, you know. You don't get the prize without going through a test. Let me repeat that again. You don't get a prize without going through the test, without passing the test first. Then you get the prize. You see, then you get the increase, you know. Verse 4, and it reads, whatsoever is brought upon thee, take cheerfully and be patient when thou art changed to a low estate. See? All right. When you might be down in the spirit because you got rebuked or, you know, you know, you might have lost a job or, anything, you know. Hey, you know, stay patient. All right. But still keep the faith. All right. Know that, it's only for a moment, man. All you got to do is pass the test, you know, for verse 5, for gold is tried in the fire. We're that gold, man. OK, the last thing you want to be is wood and stubble. You know, in the midst of fire, man. Okay. So you want to constantly stay strong, especially mentally. Number one, mentally strong, man. Okay. For gold is tried in the fire, an acceptable man in the furnace of adversity. See, adversity, man. All right. So let me get this right quick. This book of Galatians, chapter 5, and verse 17, and it reads, "For the flesh lusteth against the spirit." See, against the spirit. All right. They're at war. They're constantly at war with one another, man. All right. Your spirit and your flesh are constantly at war with one another. All right, don't forget the scripture says that we fail from our first estate, man. All right, we fail from our perfect estate, man. Okay, when we were a gods, you know, you see, serving the Lord perfectly, man. Okay, we fail from that estate. All right, and we're locked in these chains of darkness for right now, man. All right, which is this flesh. Okay, so of course your spirit being renewed daily, right? You see. And being covered, you know, you know, by Yahweh Shai, man, all right, and his blood, you know, his sacrifice, man, okay. Of course, like, your flesh is the old man, okay. Your flesh is gonna want to do the old things that you do, you know. It's gonna want to doubt. It's gonna want to be weak and tired, and you know, feel ashamed, and you know, feel guilt. You know, and things like that, man. All right. But that's why you have to always exercise your spirit, you know, more than your flesh, man. Okay. You see? It's because you want your spirit to be way stronger than your flesh, man. Your flesh is weak. All right. The scripture says that the flesh is weak, but the spirit is willing. Okay. Continuing on, it says, and the spirit against the flesh. It says, and these are contrary the one to the other, see, so that ye cannot do the things that ye would. Yeah, so your flesh is, it, you know, Satan's gonna mess with your flesh, you know, mainly your mind, right? To make you doubt, you know, a breakdown at camp, to make you doubt that if you can hold a certain position, you know, to make you doubt that it, you know, if you're a man of the Lord or not. The scriptures tell us that, you know, we're not supposed to count ourselves as that number, you know, as far as the elect, because we really don't know, right? But it says, put on as the elect, okay? You see, you're supposed to walk and be brave and, you know, have faith as the elect would have, you see? All right? So it says, verse 18, but if ye be led of the Spirit, you are not under the law. Okay, well, that goes into something else, but the point has been made. So let me go back. I want to go into this this word right here, temperance. Okay, the word temperance. So lucky if it's sideways or it looks weird right now, if it does. All right, but you go into the Etymon online. All right, the word temperance, it means self-restraint. See, moderation. All right, moderation, sobriety. You see that word sobriety, okay? All right, now I wanted to go into that word sobriety right here. Salaki, let me go into that word sobriety, okay? And when you go into the second definition down here, okay, it says the quality of being stead, okay, and or solemn, you see? Seriousness, all right? Solemnity, okay? Thoughtfulness, gravity, see? It says a severity, all right? Earnestness, dignity, a steadiness, okay? But right here, it says self-control, all right? The ability to control oneself in particular, all right? In particular, one's emotions or desire, so like, and desires or the expression of them in one's behavior, okay? Especially in difficult situations. See, you don't want to doubt. You don't want to get weak, all right? Your flesh is going to get weak, all right? Your flesh is going to try to convince you, hey, man, you can't do that, you know? It's good to exercise these things now, because just like, you know, me and the brothers were speaking last night, you know, it's good to, you know, exercise those things now, right? And make yourself strong in those areas now, because guess what? The hour of temptation is coming. And you don't know if the Lord is going to keep you from the hour of temptation or not, you know, because we're, you know, all of our faith is going to get tested, you know, one way or another, whether it be tested with that, you know, that mark, that kerygma, right? Or it be tested in other ways, man, you know, or it might be tested just in a bunch of different ways, man. All right. But your faith is going to be tested, man. All right. You know, remember, the Lord is all about faith, man. Okay. You see, when Yahweh Shai, when Yahweh Shai was walking with his men, his disciples, man, all right, he was real big on faith. He rebuked a lot of them a lot of times because of their lack of faith, man. You see? So we are to, you know, rebuke those weak thoughts that Satan puts inside of our heads, man, you know? And that's the point, you know? Let me go back to the scriptures. All right. This is the book of 1 Peter. All right. Speaking of that word sobriety. All right. 1 Peter chapter 5. All right. In verse 8, and it reads, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, all right, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may devour. See? All right, Satan wants to, you know, put doubt, you know, sow seeds of doubt inside of your flesh, man. Okay, but that's why you have to. That's why your spirit has to be more willing. All right, you have to be, you know, you have to have exercise that rebuke, you know, as far as checking yourself, man. You know. Oh man, you can't do that. That's too hard for you, man. Or ain't no way you can do that, bro. You ain't never did that before, you know. You ain't never learned that before, you know. Ain't no way you can speak, or you know, break this down in the presence of, you know, men that, you know, great men that has been doing this for, you know, a certain amount of time, you know, longer than you. You see, you got to rebuke that shit, man. Excuse my French, you know. And I'm speaking to myself first and foremost, man. You know, because this been on my spirit, man. I've been fighting the same thing, man. You know. And we all fight this, man. You know, fight those satanic thoughts, man. Verse 9, it says, whom resist steadfast in the faith, all right, knowing that the same afflictions are accomplished in your brethren that are in the world. See, so don't ever let Satan put that inside of your mind. Or they don't understand what I'm going through, because they ain't going through this, you know. You see, bros don't understand. You know, I'm trying to tell them, but they don't understand. See, that's your flesh saying that, man. You know, but that's why the Lord brought in all different types of men, all different types of Israelite men from all walks of life, man. All right. Because they've been there. They've done that, man. You can go up to them and get counseled, man. You know, you might be going through something that they went through, man. You know, now you can go seek counsel, man. You know, now you ain't got to fight and go through all the trials and tribulations that they went through, man. You know, the Lord put them there so that you can go get counsel, man. You know, fight the flesh, you know, push your pride to the side as a man. Oh, I want to go up to another man and ask them for help, you know, dealing with, you know, this or that in my personal life. No, man, go ask that man, man. OK, the Lord tells us in the scriptures to constantly seek what is that? Salaki. Let me try to find that scripture. All right. Constantly seek, Salaki. I can't think of the word. Salaki. Salaki. Damn, it slipped my mind. Lord willing to come back. Salaki. You know, but, you know, hey, go up to bros, man, you know, and, you know, seek that. Oh yeah. Constantly seek counsel. The water y'all bashing out shot. Let me see. Said constantly seek counsel. Let me see. So I can type in too fast. All right. Yep. Here we go. Right here, the Book of Sirach or Ecclesiasticus, chapter 37 and verse 16, and it reads, "Let reason go before every enterprise." Okay. So before you do anything, all right. Before you do anything, seek the counsel, man. Okay, any and everything, man. Okay, if you're not sure, you got a little bit of doubt about it. I don't know if I'm supposed to hit up a brother, man. Okay, it says, and counsel before every action. See, let reason go before every enterprise. All right, apply wisdom, right, before you do anything, and counsel before every action. See, every action, man. Okay, constantly, man. All right, let's continue. All right. Verse 10, 1 Peter 5 and 10. But the God, or the power, all right, of all grace, Yahweh, right, who hath called us, right, who have called us unto his eternal glory by Yahweh Shai Mashiach, right, after that ye have suffered a while, make you perfect. See? So through all your sufferings and your tests, your trials, right? Satan messing with your flesh, trying to sow seeds of doubt and things like that, can continue to fight. Rebuke that, all right? Rebuke yourself, okay? Rebuke yourself, man, all right? If you don't believe that, you know, you don't want to rebuke yourself, man, that's pride, man. Rebuke yourself, man. Correct yourself, you know? You know, a lot of times it don't take for another brother to come up to you and just rebuke you for, you know, doing something, man, doing something wrong. You know, look, we know, all right? You know. So rebuke yourself. Correct yourself. You know what? Hey, man, look, you ain't got to go through something. Hey, look, I'm the type of man, and I'm pretty sure a lot of brothers is like this, man. Look, I ain't got to go through certain things to know that that's not the right thing to do. You see? I can get an example from seeing another brother go through it. Okay, well, I'm not going to do that because that brother did it. And, you know, he got rebuked strongly, you know, sharply for that. You see? So rebuke yourself, man. You know? It says, make you perfect, establish, strengthen, and settle you. All right? To him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. Okay? All right? So I think it was another one. Did I read this already? Now let's go into it. I don't think I read this. This is book of 1 Timothy's. I'll close it off on this. 1 Timothy chapter 3 and verse 5, and it reads, "For if a man know not how to rule his own house, how shall he take care of the church of the Heavenly Father Yahweh?" Okay? You see? Yahweh Bashmiah was shy, man. All right? So this is twofold, all right? Your house meaning your household, right? You know, you might be ahead of your family, right? If you don't know how to rule your own, rule or lead your own household, man, okay? And get your own, get your own house in order. How can you lead and get in order, you know, the church of Yahweh Bashmiah was shy, man? All right? And then, you know, the other way is talking about your spiritual house, man, okay? Which is your flesh, you know, your body, right? You got to get yourself in order, man, okay? You got to rule over your flesh, right? So let's go into this warehouse, right? So it said a man that knoweth not how to rule over his own house, right? All right, we already established that it's talking about a house, like your actual house and your family, right? But look at here. Definition C right here at the top. It says any dwelling place of the human body as the abode of demons that possesses it. See? All right. So you got to rule your flesh, man. All right. Because, you know, a demon might jump on you or like try to, you know, Satan might try to put things in your head, doubt, you know, certain thoughts towards brothers and, you know, things of that nature, man. You got to rebuke that shit, man. Excuse my French. All right. You see? So, you know, hey, it's all about having self-control, man. Okay. All right, check yourself, right? And I'm speaking to myself first and foremost, okay? Verse 6, it says, not a novice. All right, let's go into that novice, Salakia. Just for edification's sake. Go into that word novice, not a novice, right? That word novice meaning a neophyte, all right? One who has recently become, all right, it says become a Christian, but you know, somebody new to the faith, okay? A new brother, all right? A babe, okay? All right? Because guess what? A babe, you know, a brother freshly into the truth, man, he's not going to know, you know, what to do all the time, right? But, you know, depending on, you know, your, you know, however long you've been in the truth, right? You're supposed to know, you know? All right, I myself are young in the faith, right? But you know, if a brother come in tomorrow, you know, I'm supposed to know better than him. You see, I'm supposed to know how to check, you know how and when to check myself, you know, in the spirit, man. You know, it says not a novice, least being lifted up with pride. See, if you don't want to check yourself, that's a certain level of pride, man. You know. Says, least being lifted up with pride, he fall into condemnation of the devil. Yeah, man. All right. If you don't rebuke those thoughts, that shit is going to pile up. It's going to fester, right? You know, now, you know, a certain amount of time go by. Now you hate the brotherhood. You know, you don't appreciate the brotherhood. You don't appreciate the grace that you've been given. You know, it could grow into all types of things. And then all of a sudden, boom, now you're being kicked out of the body, man. OK, the body of men. All right. Now you're out there by yourself, man. You know, and now you're susceptible to all types of demons, man. You know. And guess what? You haven't even exercised or learned how to rebuke yourself, man, and rebuke those wicked thoughts. So now you pretty much met, you know, excuse my French, you're fucked, you know. And we see examples of that, you know, men that have fell out. Now they just hate the brotherhood. They hate everything they've been taught by those men and everything, man. You don't want to do that, man. Especially now we're at the end, man. All right. This is the worst time to try to, you know, this is the worst time to fall out of the truth, man. OK. Because now you're going to have men, just like it says in the scriptures, man. Now you're going to have men, all right, that are you know still have their hands to the plow, going to be looking at you laughing, man, scoffing at you, man. Like, hey, look, he didn't have what it took to finish, man, to finish building, man. You know? He didn't prepare himself, you know, to make sure he had everything he needed to finish the job, man. You know, you don't want to be that guy. I don't want to be that guy, man. You know, Yahweh Ratzah, man, we're not, you know. So I'm going to end it there. You know, Lord willing, this is edifying to the body and the faith of the sheep through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. Double honors to my apostles and elders of great millstone who do rule and teach well. Shalom and the Baba Ball.